Hey guys, it's Peter here. In this video, I'll be solving the number 8 most popular kata or code challenge on Codewars. This problem is called Stop Spinning My Words, and the description says, write a function that takes in a string of one or more words and return the same string, but with all 5 or more letter words reversed, like the name of this kata. Strings passed in will consist of only letters and spaces. Spaces will be included only when more than one word is present. Okay, so immediately it seems like we need to find a way to iterate over the words in the string sentence. We can do this by using the string method called split. This, by default, breaks up the string on white spaces and returns a list of elements, which in this case are words of the sentence. We can then iterate over each word, and if the length is greater than or equal to 5, reverse it and append it to a new list of words. After iterating over every word, we can then join together the new word list using spaces to return a converted sentence string. In Python, the easiest and most efficient way to reverse a string is to use this weird syntax called extended slicing. We can of course use the reverse function and then join the characters together, but this is much more awkward and slower in performance. Okay, perfect. Before we go, let me show you the one-line version of the previous solution. But please keep in mind that one-line solutions are generally not very readable, and you should try your best to aim for readability over conciseness. So in order to convert the previous for loop into a one-line solution, we will use something called a generator expression, which is very similar to list comprehensions. So we want to join for word in sentence.split. Append the reverse word if length is greater than 5. Otherwise, append the word as it is. And there we go. By using generator expressions or list comprehensions, we can often reduce our code down to just one line. Alright, and that's it. I hope you were able to learn a few things from this video. If you have any questions about this problem or about Python, please feel free to ask them in the comment section down below. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next coding video. Thanks!